Hi, this is Yosif Tseroyannis and Manos Brilakis from the Minneapolis Heart Institute and the Cardiovascular Innovations Foundation, presenting case 76 for the manual of percutaneous coronary intervention. This is a case illustrating challenges with wiring a tortuous right coronary artery. The patient was a 60-year-old gentleman who presented with class 3 angina and was found to have inferior ischemia on a nuclear stress test. He also had COPD and diabetes. His angiogram showed a significant lesion in the mid-right coronary artery and a CTO of the mid-LAD after the takeoff of a large diagonal branch. There was actually a brief attempt for recanalizing the LAD CTO at the time of diagnostic angiography by a different operator. The patient was subsequently referred to us for recanalizing the native right coronary artery after he declined coronary bypass graft surgery. Looking at this right coronary artery, it becomes immediately apparent that this is likely going to be a complex intervention, mainly because of the severe tortuosity of the right coronary artery, but also because the right coronary artery is supplying the left anterior descending artery, which is occluded, and therefore compromising the flow in the right could have a significant impact on the perfusion on the LAD and precipitate potentially hemodynamic collapse. So how to approach such lesions? Complex lesions are important to be approached with strong guide catheter support. This can be obtained by using long sheaths or large size sheaths such as an 8 or 7 French, using supportive shape guide catheters such as AL1 for the right, deeply engaging the guide catheter, or using body wires. The second line is to use guide catheter extensions such as the guideliner / trapliner, Godzilla and telescope currently available in the US, or by using the side branch anchoring technique with a balloon inflated on the side branch of a coronary artery proximal to the target lesion. In this particular case, we ended up using an 8 French sheath in the femoral artery. However, we did not use an 8 French guide because we did have some friction on moving the catheter. So we ended up using a 7 French guide catheter. We used a JR4 after using an AL1 which failed to engage. The 7 French JR4. Then we tried to get a trapliner, 6 French trapliner into the artery. However, this was challenging. To facilitate engagement, we went back, and because of aortic tortuosity and difficulty manipulating the guide, we changed for a 45 centimeter long 8 French sheath, and then used the same guide that was 1 French smaller inside the sheath, and this significantly facilitated manipulation of the guide. So when there is iliac tortuosity, having a guide that is slightly smaller than the long sheath can really help with facilitating movement of the guide catheter and transmission of torque from the back end to the front end. We also had difficulty wiring. You see, engagement is not perfect and the wire kept on entering the marginal branch, but eventually by moving the guide catheter and redirecting the guide wire, we're able to advance it into the proximal right coronary artery. We knew that support was going to be poor, so we tried to reinsert the trapliner, and we did that using the inch-warming technique. This was actually very challenging and took several attempts, but eventually we were able to inflate the balloon partially in and out of the guide extension, deflate the balloon, and then the trapliner did go down into the right coronary artery, which provided us some strong support. Also, having the trapliner with the balloon proximally facilitated inserting microcatheters. But the problem was, after a brief wiring attempt, the guide extension and the guide position were lost. We decided to change plans and use a side branch anchoring technique. This is again a JR4 with a wire inserted into this large acute marginal branch. And then we inserted a 2.0 millimeter balloon into this branch that provided support to the guide catheter, and were then able to advance a Caravel microcatheter into the proximal and mid-right coronary artery. And then the Caravel was actually delivered just proximal to the lesion, providing us good support. We did experience difficulty wiring, and that is why we took a picture injecting through the Caravel, and that demonstrates a complex appearance of the lesion with a spiral pattern. it almost looked like the patient had a filling defect, almost like a fibromuscular dysplasia or calcification. However, there was not really much calcification in the remaining of the coronary artery. At this point, we used intermittent balloon inflations in the marginal branch, and we used several guide wires, including the Sion, Fielder FC, Sion Black, Suoh 3, Pilot 200, and Gladius Mongo. So soft wires as well as polymer jacket stiff wires. And as you can see, the wire kept on assuming a pigtail configuration. It was very hard to advance it through the lesion. And we tried this actually for a long period of time. And the concern here was that if we get more aggressive and get stiffer wires, such as guidewires, we potentially dissect the right coronary artery and lose the perfusion of the right and potentially compromise the perfusion on the left. So after multiple attempts, we decided to abandon and actually stop the procedure and remove the equipment. We then referred the patient again for consideration of surgery. In this case, does provide several interesting lessons. The first one is the challenges with tortuosity. Tortuosity can hinder advancement of equipment and makes support very important. To obtain support, there are different techniques. We use several of them in this case, including a 8 French 45 centimeter long sheath, a 7 French guide catheter. We tried a trapliner guide extension. We tried the side branch anchoring technique, and we did try using microcatheter to support our guide wire. Despite that, and despite using multiple guide wires, we were unable to cross the lesion due to the complex lesion morphology. And the decision was made to stop because the potential complications of dissecting the lesion and causing acute vessel closure might have been catastrophic. So knowing when to stop is important. Sometimes having a failed case, but the patient being okay, is better than having a successful quote-unquote case, but the patient having a compromise or a major complication. Thank you very much.